बच रहा, एक थारे से एक कचहरी से, थारे से बच गया, कचहरी में फंस गया। गुड टू बी हियर साहब, बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका टू बी इनवाइटेड एंड ऑनर टू बी हियर। मैं अपना थोड़ा तारुफ करा दूँ फिर कुछ बातें करेंगे। सलीम गौरी नाम है मेरा और मैं फाउंडर हूँ नेटसोल टेक्नोलॉजीज का, CEO भी हूँ। 24 साल हो गए हमें कंपनी डेवलप करते, लंबा अरसा है, लॉन्ग साइकिल, लेकिन IT की लाइफ में को बड़ा टाइम नहीं। किसी भी अच्छी चीज़ को अगर आपने बनाना है तो उस पर टाइम लगता है। बहुत से बच्चे मेरे पास आते हैं मेंटोरिंग के लिए और वो सवाल करते हैं कि हम काम कर रहे हैं, बहुत अच्छा बीत गया लेकिन काम बढ़ नहीं रहा, वही क्यों है। तो मैं एक बात समझाता हूँ कि अच्छी चीज़ हमेशा टाइम लगता है, इट टेक्स टाइम टू बिल्ड समथिंग गुड, इट विल टेक टाइम, नथिंग गुड विल हैपन इन अ शॉर्टर पीरियड। यही सर हमारी एग्जाम्पल है, 24 साल लग गए। जब मैंने काम शुरू किया, मैं ऑस्ट्रेलिया से नया नया आया पाकिस्तान, बड़े ख्वाब लेके आया, ऑस्ट्रेलिया में अच्छी जिंदगी छोड़ दी, पाकिस्तान आया कि IT कंपनी बनाऊंगा। आ गया लाहौर और बड़ी उम्मीद थी कि IT से ताल्लुक है मेरा और लोगों को बहुत ज़रूरत होगी पाकिस्तान में टेक्नोलॉजी की। तो विद इन फ्यू मंथ्स मेरे ख्वाब सारे चकनाचूर हो गए, क्योंकि 96 में उस वक्त भी अभी IT का एक्सेप्टेबिलिटी बहुत कम थी, पीपल वर नॉट रेडी कि वो अपने आप को ऑटोमेट करें, डिजिटाइज करें या टेक्नोलॉजी को इंट्रोड्यूस करें। तो मैं एक दफ़ा एक दोस्त के पास बैठा हुआ था, बहुत उदास सा शक्ल बना के बैठा। दोस्त ने पूछा क्या हुआ भाई, मैं कहा यार कंपनी बनाई है बट कुछ हो नहीं रहा। उसने कहा यार सलीम डोंट वरी, 3 साल लगा लो, 3 साल बन गए तो तुम्हारी कंपनी बन जाएगी। सर 3 साल गुजर गए, कंपनी नहीं बनी, फिर मैं उदास बैठा था। फिर वही दोस्त आके मिले, मैं कहा यार तुमने कहा था 3 साल में कंपनी बन जाएगी, अभी कुछ नहीं बना। कह रहे यार डोंट वरी, 5 साल लगा लो कंपनी बन जाएगी। 5 साल भी गुजर गए, फिर वही मामला, फिर उदासी, फिर वो दोस्त आए। तो वो बेचारे मुझे तसली देते रहे और मैं उनकी तसली से आगे बढ़ता रहा। बट आई डू रियलाइज इट टेक्स टाइम, नथिंग गुड विल हैपन इन अ शॉर्ट पीरियड। बट नेटसोल माशाल्लाह टुडे आज एक बहुत बड़ी इंटरप्राइज है, और सिर्फ ये नहीं कि बड़ी है, इसने पाकिस्तान को ग्लोबली इंट्रोड्यूस करा दिया इन टेक्नोलॉजी। आज हमारे कस्टमर्स ग्लोबल हैं, कस्टमर्स अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। इनफैक्ट पाकिस्तान में वी हैव नो कस्टमर्स, हम पाकिस्तान में नहीं बेचते, लेकिन ग्लोबली वी आर वन ऑफ द बेस्ट प्रोवाइडर ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर जिसपे हम काम करते हैं। सो नेटसोल हैज़ अचीव्ड इट्स गोल इन लास्ट 24 ईयर्स। हमारा फोकस रहा फाइनेंशियल एप्लीकेशंस में और अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह वी आर वेरी सक्सेसफुल इन दैट। बट सब्जेक्ट आज का नेटसोल नहीं है, आज का सब्जेक्ट टेक्नोलॉजी है और उसका इम्पैक्ट हमारी सोसाइटी पे। अभी हमने जस्ट देखा PITB की एक काविश, एक कोशिश सिर्फ ईस्टर्न के उससे, जस्ट ईस्टर्न को ऑटोमेट करने से कितनी अमेजिंग चेंज है रेवेन्यू में, प्रॉफिट में और एबिलिटी अकाउंटेबिलिटी में। कि नाउ इफ यू लुक एट द नंबर्स ऑफ ईस्टर्न्स, जो पहले नॉर्मल वो स्टेप पेपर था और जब ईस्टर्न है, इट्स अ रिमार्केबल डिफरेंस। सो एक बहुत छोटी एग्जाम्पल है कि टेक्नोलॉजी की इम्प्लीमेंटेशन से हाउ वी कैन चेंज आवर टोटल सोसाइटी। देयर आर अ वेरी डिफरेंट वर्ल्ड, दुनिया इस वक्त बहुत तेज़ी से चेंज उसमें आ रही है। हम इसको 4th revolution कहते हैं। ये दुनिया इससे पहले 3 revolution से गुजर चुकी है, चाहे वो स्टीम रेवोल्यूशन हो, इलेक्ट्रिक रेवोल्यूशन हो या इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन हो, इसका अपना कंप्यूटराइजेशन का, दे वर ऑल वन बाय वन दुनिया उससे गुजरी है। अब इस वक्त हम 4th revolution में हैं, जिसको नॉर्मली हम IoT कहते हैं, इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स या डिजिटाइजेशन ऑफ सोसाइटी कहते हैं। पाकिस्तान पिछले 70 साल में बहुत कुछ मिस कर आया। वी हैव मिस्ड इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन, वी हैव मिस्ड, यू नो, हमें अभी तक वी आर स्टिल ट्राइंग टू स्ट्रगल, हम अभी भी स्ट्रगल करें एज ए नेशन कि हम क्या हैं, हम किस चीज़ में अच्छे हैं, व्हाट डू वी डू। टोटल एक्सपोर्ट हमारी $21 बिलियन विद अ पॉपुलेशन ऑफ 220 मिलियन, हमारी एक्सपोर्ट सिर्फ $21 बिलियन की है। कल रात को मैं सिंगापुर से वापस आया हूँ, मुल्क मेरे 6 लाख का मुल्क है और उनकी एक्सपोर्ट ओवर $100 बिलियन है, वेरी स्मॉल कंट्री विद $100 बिलियन एक्सपोर्ट। यहाँ पर वी आर अ 220 मिलियन पॉपुलेशन विद ऑल द रिसोर्सेज, विद ऑल रॉ मटेरियल अवेलेबल, स्टिल हमारी एक्सपोर्ट इज $21 मिलियन। इट मीन्स कि वी हैव मिस्ड आउट, वी हैव मिस्ड आउट मैनी अपॉर्चुनिटीज। हम किसी भी मौके से नहीं सके। वेल इस वक्त है पाकिस्तान का इस नई जो एक रेवोल्यूशन है इससे फायदा उठाने का। इट इज़ कॉल्ड डिजिटाइजेशन ऑफ सोसाइटी। इसे हम डिसरप्शन भी कहते हैं, यानी हमारी लाइफ में डिसरप्शन आ रही है, वी बीन डिसरप्टेड। जो काम हम एक करते थे अब वो काम उस तरह नहीं, डिफरेंट तरीके से होगा। चेंज आ गया है पूरी सोसाइटी में। पाकिस्तान एज अ होल कैन टेक द बेनिफिट ऑफ दैट। वी आर क्वाइट कैपेबल टू टेक द बेनिफिट। नाउ इट्स अप टू अस कि हम इससे फ़ायदा उठाते कि उठाते। मैं दोबारा नेटसोल की एग्जाम्पल आपको देता हूँ। नेटसोल कंपनी स्टैब्लिश की गई थी, टोटल कैपिटल हमारा 20 लाख रुपया था 1996 में टोटल, और वो पूरा कैपिटल था वही पैसे जो फैमिली से मैंने इकट्ठे किए। आज नेटसोल जनरेट करता है $10 बिलियन की रुपीज़ की रेवेन्यू। सिर्फ 20 लाख से 10 बिलियन की हम रेवेन्यू पर ईयर जनरेट करते हैं। दैट इज़ हाउ IT कैन इफेक्ट द सोसाइटी। आप कोई इंडस्ट्री लगाइए, यू विल रिक्वायर्ड ओवर $100 मिलियन टू पुट अप अ मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट, नॉट इन IT। IT इज वन सेक्टर विच इज़ क्रिएटेड विद नथिंग, जस्ट योर इंटेलेक्चुअल वैल्यूज एंड योर आइडियाज। दैट्स ऑल यू नीड टू बिल्ड आर इंडस्ट्री। एंड नेटसोल इज अ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट बिजनेसिस एंड अ कंप्लीट इंडस्ट्री विद वेरी लिटल इन आवर रिसोर्सिस और इन मनी वाइज। फॉर लास्ट 24 ईयर्स आई बी स्ट्रगलिंग इन पाकिस्तान टू रियली प्रमोट IT इंडस्ट्री, एंड इट बीन वेरी फ्रस्ट्रेटेड। पाकिस्तान नॉट बीन ईजी, क्योंकि वजह ये थी कि पिछले 15 साल से हम एक वॉर लड़े थे टेररिज्म में। विद ऑल आवर सक्सेस वी वर नॉट एबल टू ब्रिंग द बिजनेस टू पाकिस्तान। पाकिस्तान आने को कोई तैयार नहीं था, क्योंकि कोई नो बडी वॉज विलिंग टू कम टू पाकिस्तान। जब वो पाकिस्तान नहीं आएंगे तो वो हमें काम भी नहीं देंगे। तो इट हैज़ बीन वेरी रफ रोड फॉर लास्ट 20 ईयर्स, नॉट एनी मोर। पाकिस्तान हैज़ ओपन अप, लोग पाकिस्तान आ रहे हैं, पीपल आर ट्रेवलिंग टू पाकिस्तान। सो दिस इज़ द टाइम फॉर पाकिस्तान to build its IT industry completely. Technology is one sector which is going to change our society. Aur usse zyada main aapko bataunga ki aapke apna jo legal profession hai that is impacted very rapidly with technology. Globally agar aap trend dekhe, legal fraternity jo aapki hai gradually isme change ho rahi hai. Use of technology is very high around the world. Wherever you go they are using, every bit of work done by lawyers is used, behind that they use all the information available globally. I'm not sure कि आप लोग कितना इसको यूज़ करें, but globally आपको पता है कि मल्टीपल जॉब्स जा रहे हैं। द जॉब्स आर, वी आर लूजिंग जॉब्स। बैंक्स जॉब्स आर ग्रेजुअली डिक्रीजिंग, मशीन्स आर टेकिंग ओवर। विद ATM कमिंग अप, पीपल डोंट गो टू द बैंक क्लर्क टू गेट द मनी। आप ATM से यू नो यू गेट योर मनी आउट। इट मीन्स वी आर गेटिंग रिड ऑफ द क्लर्क्स, बैंक क्लर्क्स। दिस इज हैपनिंग इन एवरी एरिया, एवरी स्फीयर। कार्स will be driverless, it's just a matter of time, aapki cars are going to be without driver. Aur ye main aapko wo kar raha hoon, globally it's already starting. So we'll lose a big chunk of job. The cars will be electric. Kya matlab is baat ka? You will lose lots of job with mechanics. Hazaron log is tarah kaam kar rahe hain on mechanical cars, they will all lose their jobs when we get electrical cars. Electrical car mein sirf ek component hai sir, sirf ek component, motor, that's all. Mechanical car mein you have thousands of parts, so you need mechanics and workshops to fix that. We are talking about jobs and jobs and jobs. Those jobs will be gone, your jobs will disappear, because electrical cars are reality. Sari countries have 2030 ka target de diya, they will gradually get rid of all fuel, fossil fuel cars, and will get into electric car. That's going to gradually. Pakistan will follow. When Pakistan follows and gradually we get electric cars, it means there's a big segment of jobs will be lost, because this car will require just to change the motor and your car is running again. There will be no mechanics required. One more example. Doesn't matter which area you're going, technology is going to replace people very rapidly. In law, there's a software called Watson from IBM. Big law firms are now depending more on getting case studies from Watson, then they're asking their juniors to sit and write down the test, whatever you call them, sir, cases ko kya kehte hain aap log, preparation jo aap case ki karte hain. That is going to impact a lot in the law fraternity, because gradually there'll be less lawyers needed in the world, because machines will help you do your case. One lawyer will not need 10 more assistants to do their work. Now that's a change, it's already happening. Abhi aaj aap dekh lijiye ya iska wait kar lijiye, but we are in that world where law will be affected by technology. There's so much data already available on all the presidencies in the world or all the courts in the world on the net, that you don't need to go through the books anymore, or you don't need anybody to help you. You can view your own cases without any help at all. So that is the deception you will face. Kitne logon ke paas smartphone hai? How many people got smartphones? I guess everyone. Can I ask you a question? How many of we use to search information out of it? Let's just be, how many of us use this phone to search information? How many of us search in this information? This is the most powerful device you can have in your pocket. It's not expensive anymore, sir. It's expensive. Nahi hai. Chinese made smartphones are 12-13,000 mein aapko mil jayega. But they are the most powerful tools today you can have. This is full of so much information that you cannot imagine if you go and start searching it, sir. So, sir, for you, sir, legal fraternity, you have to start realizing the power of phones you have got. Agar main kisi doctor ke paas bhi jata hun aur agar wo mujhe dawai medication prescribe karta hai, main dawai foran leta hun, main kya karta hun? Pehle jaake main search karta hun. Agar koi mera legal case hai, agar mujhe koi advice chahiye, yakeen kijiye, pehle main pura isko dhoondta rehta hun ki duniya mein pehle kya hua hai. Aaj tak Lahore to main khud ban gaya. Constantly main baitha is pe dekhta hun kis case mein kya hua. This is, sir, going to happen to all your other clients also. Gradually, the new generation clients will do their homework very, very well. When they come to you and ask you to defend them, they would have done their homework very, very well. Same with the doctor. Mere doctor ko bhi samjhar hona pad gaya, kyunki doctor mujhse woh nahi kar sakta. Aye bhai shay. Jaane se pehle main apne khud diagnose kar leta hu mujhe problem kya hai, mere symptoms kya hai. Pura symptoms pe dalta hu, mujhe pura aa jata hai ki aapko ye issue ho sakta hai. Now when I go to a doctor and I talk to a doctor, tell him, yaar mujhe khansi hai, mujhe nazla aayi hai, main doctor se dekho mujhe kya kahega, what is going to tell me about my condition aur mujhe kya medication prescribe karega. वो मेडिकेशन मुझे बताएगा, आई मे एग्री विद हिम नॉट, एंड देन जो मेडिकेशन देगा मैं पूरा जब तक तसल्ली नहीं करूँगा कि मेडिकेशन का इम्पैक्ट मुझ पर क्या है, मैं दवाई यूज नहीं करूँगा. सिंपल एज दैट. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड डिसरप्शन. वी आर बीइंग डिसरप्टेड, यानी द वे वी यूज टू डू थिंग्स इन द पास्ट यस्टरडे वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू डू इट टुमारो. टेक्नोलॉजी इज प्लेइंग अ रोल इन आवर लाइफ. एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, सर, इन एवरी स्फीयर, आपकी हर लाइफ के उसमें टेक्नोलॉजी का इम्पैक्ट है. चाहे वो आपके बच्चे की एजुकेशन है, या आपका बिजनेस है, या आपका प्रोफेशन है, लीगल प्रोफेशन और एनी अदर प्रोफेशन, टेक्नोलॉजी इज हैविंग अ ग्रेट इम्पैक्ट ऑन दैट. मेरा 5 साल का सब बेटा है, वो टाइप नहीं कर सकता, लेकिन वो वॉइस से गूगल कंट्रोल करता है पूरा. He's controlling Google with voice and he's getting sites, which I can't imagine how he does that. Can you imagine कि एक 5 साल का बच्चा जब है, as he grow up, how much she will be comfortable with a device like that? I'm just worried that will he learn to write? Because going forward, he will do all the work with the voice. It's changing. You can talk to this phone and the phone will get you the information out of it when you talk to it. If you don't know how to type, talk to it. What does that mean? How is it going to change that? So even the education system is going to be disrupted, already been disrupted. All these hard copies of material we have got is obsolete. Because they were printed a year ago. Same information has changed just 2 days back. So how come that book is good for me? So I'm just talking to the HSC and others. We are really getting behind. Information is, at the moment, is not of the past. It's changing every day. We're getting new ideas about how, you know, things are done. So that's how education should be changed. So the kids from the schools needs to, you know, get the new type of education. Our today's education is absolute. The jobs they are prepared for will not be there tomorrow. Jin jobs ke liye hum prepared kar rahe hain, wo jobs kal nahi honge. Chahe wo finance ke education hai, business education hai, science education hai, all is changing very rapidly. I am very concerned about Pakistan education in research, that I believe that in 5 years time, the students aayenge graduate ke, they will have a problem getting the jobs. Because when my company want to hire somebody, we don't look at the degree at all, we look at the skill set they have got. Because we are paying someone to do a job. If they just show me a piece of paper but they don't have the skills to do the job, I will not hire them. Now that's a serious problem. So it means that they have to get a different education and they have to get a different skill set. Now that is not a good, you know, news for all of us. How do we prepare our young kids so they, when they come out, they are employable? And I have a problem today. The current batch of students coming out, we are spending so much money in training them. We're training our biggest chunk of our revenue goes on training of people when we hire, because they are not up to date with the skill sets and they are not up to date with the technology of today, because technology is also changing every day. So some deception is real. It's going to be here and it's going to change. Every day we are going to see new ideas coming out and how we go by it. I keep saying, your banks will be cashless, your shops will be goodsless, because now you're buying most of goods, you know, e-commerce will be, you'll be buying a lot of things online. I never used to buy anything online. Last few years, it's easier. I just keep looking for what I like and they deliver at my home. The food is coming to my home. All is changing very rapidly. The e-commerce side of it is going to change more rapidly. We are in 4G now. Hopefully within the next 2 years, we'll have 5G. 5G information will change very quickly. Information movement will be so rapid and quick that we will be able to access data more quickly. Two things we're going to have. We have lots of data about us. There's so much data collected around the world, and there's a speed of movement of data. Now that will change the society very quickly. Are we ready for that? I don't think so we're ready for that. Pakistan itself can benefit. Pakistan can benefit from these changes because we are as ready like anybody else. Now we need to grab that, the opportunities in that. Pakistan is number 4 in the world in freelancing. Now what is freelancing? Ye wo bachche hain jo ghar baithke global kaam karte hain. Isko hum freelancing kehte hain. Yani they are not employed. Ye employed nahi hai. Ye ghar baithke net pe jaake kisi ki assignment likh di, kisi ki thesis likh di, kisi ka website bana di, kisi ka software chota sa likh diya. They are called freelancer. Pakistan globally is number 4 in the world. That's a big ranking. 4 lakh zyada bachche isse ghar bache bachiyan ghar baithke software develop karte hain ya logon ki thesis likhte hain ya log jo home ghar baithke karte hain. That's a big industry. World has changed completely. Pakistan has changed completely. But now we need to change more rapidly. We need to digitize very quickly. We are behind. We saw what PITB is doing. PITB has done a lot of work for automation. Have we implemented that? Are we going to use it benefitly? We're just avoiding the reality of the life. The real world is going to move faster. I was just in Singapore yesterday. It's amazing how much digitization they have done. The lives have completely changed around the world. We in Pakistan are still lagging behind. Let's not do that, sir. You play a very important role, sir, all of you, sir. You are responsible so much. One more subject is very important I would raise is IP right protection. IT industry is not growing because we are not able to defend our IP rights at all. The serious issue of software development or ideas are just ideas and they're developed. Ideas are created by one person and they're divided by people. The founder will hire few people to convert the idea into a product. What's happening is that after some work and the employees, they leave the company and then they start developing themselves. That is called IP right violation community. We are not able to understand that. Even our, so far, I don't know if our legal system understand that its impact society make. Nobody is willing to invest now. I'm not willing to invest anymore in the new ideas because my idea is not protected. Anybody is able to copy my idea, anybody working for me for 2 years, mere paise pe, mere salary di, mere train kiya, unhone kaam kiya, aur wo phir ja ke, they start developing, mere cheeze bhi le ja ke, main unko rok bhi sakta. I cannot stop them, and that is going to hamper the development in Pakistan. Jab tak ke aap log IP right ki importance ko appreciate nahi karenge, we are helpless. The legal fraternity has to understand and appreciate how important it is to defend and protect IP rights of people. Wohi log hai jinhone naya Pakistan banana hai. They are the people who are going to come up with new ideas. Take the example of Facebook. It was an idea, just idea of a social network. Create a social network where people get together. That was just an idea, nothing yet. WhatsApp is an idea where people can talk to, chat with each other. What is the idea? LinkedIn is an idea where professionals get together, just an idea. All these would have not possible if people were able to copy in USA and leave Mark Zuckerberg and start their own Facebook. Wouldn't be possible. Facebook kabhi nahi milta. But in Pakistan, we have a serious dilemma here at all. Agar cases aaye bhi hain, to legally unko prosecute karna bada mushkil hai. It's very difficult to defend. Kyunki there's no tangible. There's no tangible to see ke kya bana hai. But it's all court and software, it's all words. No, legality is you have to defend. Sir, ispe please do visit it, to think about it, because Pakistan can grow very rapidly. IT industry can build Pakistan very quickly. As I give you example of Netsol, only with 2 million rupees, we generate 10 billion revenue. We have 1,700 people employed in Lahore. We have got 300 people employed globally. We have 11 business centers around the world. We have captured China's market, 90% of China's market. We sell to China where everybody import from China, we export to China, sir. We are the biggest exporter to China in the last 10 years. That's only because of technology. We cannot export anything else to China. What do we do? Textile? Not much. But technology, sir, we are. This is possible because of we are able to build our IT industry. And sir, I request you all to take it, in your plan, look at it. How can we defend people's IP right completely? So I can keep talking and I keep going, but I just wanted to, like to close my talk and again, just raising this concern of how legally and the lawyers can benefit from technology, sir. There's so much power out there for you to tap into. And sir, again, the concept of technology being expensive, sir, is not right. It is not very, very economical for all of us to benefit from it. As I said, devices are not expensive. We just need to really understand how to get the information and knowledge out of it. And I believe we can do a much better job if we are, able to learn to use this tool. And ultimately, this is going to convert from a phone to an actual device which will take care of all our way of life. This will control from my AC to my car, to my home security, to my voice, to my presentations, to my knowledge tapping, sir, this is the device. And the new devices are coming in very rapidly. They will overshadow what we have got today, sir. Sir, with that, I really like to thank you all for being here, present to listen to me. I'm really honored, sir, you invited me. And I hope that I'm able to share my thoughts to you members, sir. Sir, thank you very much, sir. Thanks a lot.